Welcome to Techzilla Bytes, feeding your tech hunger fast. I'm Shannon Morse. The Worldwide Developer Conference, aka Apple's WWDC, just kicked off this week in San Francisco, and we've been introduced to some pretty cool new updates for iOS and OS X. So first off, in OS X land, an update is coming called Yosemite. And guess what, folks? It's free, and it'll be available in the fall. The new clean and translucent interface is still totally old school Apple, but everything looks a bit more like it belongs together in one fluid platform. A couple of apps have been updated in OS X 2, including Newbie iCloud Drive, which can integrate folders and tags and sync across all sorts of Apple devices, and the ability to view your drive as an Explorer folder in Windows. It kind of sounds similar to Dropbox, but wait, there's more. I've had occasions where I have wanted to send big files to people, but I can't because my email service says that the file is too big. MailDrop is a service that'll let you send files up to 5 gigs from one Mac to another directly, or you can send a download link to your non-Mac homies. Also in Mail, we get a new and useful markup tool that is supposed to let you use your trackpad to make notes, you can sign documents, and draw arrows on pictures. Because I am tired of having to print out a PDF, sign it physically, scan it, and then email it back to a person. Maybe this will save me some time. My other favorite from the keynote is the hotspot for your iPhone. Your Mac will notice your iPhone when it is in range, and then you can connect to it. No password required, which sounds a little bit scary to me. It'll let you make and take phone calls on your Mac, click a phone number on a website if you want to call, and even send messages to non-iMessage people. Like, yay, Androids! Before we get back to the madness that is WWDC, get rid of that 5 o'clock shadow with a sweet shave. For a few bucks a month, Dollar Shave Club ships amazing razors and other bathroom stuff right to your door. So shave time, shave money, and join now at dollarshaveclub.com/techzilla. And the other big hitter was iOS 8. We now get interactive notifications, search tools, and a better mail experience. Do you ever get those really annoying group texts from people that never seem to shut up until like 3 o'clock in the morning? Yeah. Me too. Now you can leave a group text, you can turn it to do not disturb, you can add or remove folks from a group message, and you can also send pictures, videos, and voice messages through the group. Now, sounds like a better experience, but not as cool as the HomeKit or HealthKit, which are supposed to take all of those proprietary company apps like Fitbits and your hospital's app, or your Philips Hue and your smart thermostat, and it integrates them into one interface so that you can access all of your data in one place. Sounds pretty cool. Apple seems to be a bit more open and welcoming this year in regards to third-party apps, now letting them share between themselves and with iOS 8 software, so you can see Pinterest come up as a sharing option while browsing in a third-party browser. You can even download new third-party widgets for things in your notification center. And for developers, there's a fun-looking new programming language called Swift that is similar to Objective-C. I'm really looking forward to playing with this myself because I'm kind of a geek when it comes to programming languages. Now for more from Techzilla, hit up youtube.com/techzilla or techzilla.com and share what you think below or tweet me at Techzilla. I'm Shannon Morse. Thanks for watching.